It's Siani Lin, and you're watching Disney Channel. Hey guys, it's Siani Lin, and welcome back to my channel. Today, we're gonna do a much requested video. Occasionally, I post on my Instagram and I ask you guys what kind of videos you want to see, and the skincare routine was one of the most requested, so that's what we're going to do today. So I have all my products laid out. I'm going to try to explain as I'm doing it. I usually do my skincare routine in the shower, so it's going to be a little hard, but I'm going to try to explain all my steps, and I don't want this video to be too long, so we're going to get straight into it. Okay, so the first step before you do anything is if you're waking up, or even like if it's just in the middle of the day, like you haven't washed your face yet, you always want to wash your hands because you know your hands carry a lot of germs. You want to wash your hands anyway, but especially when it comes to dealing with your skin because it will transfer and that can cause a lot of breakouts. Okay, so I washed my hands very well and then I wet my face a little bit. And the reason why I wet my face is because for the first step, which I don't do all the time, I just do it when I feel like my skin needs it. I'm going to go in with my homemade honey and sugar scrub. This is like a face mask I use for exfoliating. I made my own because my skin is really sensitive. I really don't trust a lot of products, and I really like to know what I'm putting on my face, my skin, my body, anything. So my face is wet because once I put this on, it kind of helps for it to like melt into my skin. So yeah, exfoliating can be a little harsh, so it's really important that like you don't do it too often and you don't do it too rough when you're actually applying it. Only thing about this is it can get messy, that's why I like to do it in the bathroom, but for the sake of this video, I'm going to try to do it on the screen. I can feel it like kind of sliding, but usually when I do it in the bathroom, I don't leave this on for long. I just like do what I need to do with it. I just rub it into my skin and then I take it off so I can cleanse. But for the sake of this video, I'm gonna tell you the benefits of this mask. So like I said, this mask is made out of just sugar and honey. Tell you guys about the benefits of honey first. So honey consists of amino acids, contains antiseptics, and it has antibiotic properties. It's really rich in vitamins and it helps heal wounds, and it also can be very moisturizing for your skin, which is very much needed for someone like me who has dry skin, dry sensitive skin. I'm glad that it's a natural product that I can put on my face. As far as sugar, sugar acts as a natural exfoliant and it helps with shedding dead skin cells. This is great for when it comes to applying your products because you know it's going straight into your skin. It's not sitting on top of your dead skin cells. It has soothing properties, and sugar helps to provide a natural glow. Okay, so I can literally feel it like falling off my skin. It's like melting. So I'm gonna go to the bathroom and wash it off. And when you wash it off, just make sure that you're working it into your skin. I'm gonna wash this off and I'll be right back. As you can see, I went and rinsed it off my face and I left my face a little wet. And I did that on purpose because we're about to apply the cleanser. My face is a little red from the exfoliator. That's why I try not to do it too often or like do it too harshly. Because you can see like, I don't know what this is, this little spot. It just got red, but we're gonna ignore that. So as far as cleansers, I feel like your skincare routine should always change with the season. So I use two different cleansers based on the season. So in the fall and the winter, I use Noxzema because that's when my face is at its driest. And with Noxzema, it doesn't really strip your face, but it also gives you a deep clean. I feel like it's important in those months because you don't want your skin to be even drier than it already is during this time. For spring and summer, I use Dr. Bronner's Pure Castile Soap because my skin isn't as dry as it is during the colder months. But you know, this still gets a very deep clean. The only thing about this cleanser is you have to be careful when you're applying it and leaving it on. Like, you cannot leave this on for a long time because it will burn you. It's really strong. You're supposed to dilute it with water. That's another reason why I keep water on my face and I apply more water, especially when I'm using this, because it is very, very strong and it will burn you if you leave it on for too long. I'm speaking from experience. I'm just gonna add a little bit, about like that much. Get it into my face. because it's not in the water right. So I'm about to go rinse this off while still working it into my face. And I'll be right back. Okay, so that's rinsed off. As you can tell, my skin is still wet because I do not use a towel to dry my face. So I just try to let my face air dry when I get out the shower. So right now, it's going to be still a little wet, but that's okay because we're about to apply another product, but the product will kind of dry with our face. Next product I'm going to use is aloe vera gel. I love aloe anything. I like aloe juice. I have aloe plant. Aloe vera is just all in all a great plant. So aloe has antioxidants, enzymes, and vitamins A and C. It's anti-inflammatory, which is why a lot of people use it for burns. It treats acne and is very good for dry skin. And it's also UV resistant, so it acts as a natural sunblock. Sun can be very damaging to your skin, so you want to make sure you're always wearing some type of sunblock. If you don't want to wear a sunblock because of like the white cast, you can always use aloe vera gel. It's clear and it won't leave any type of cast, and you can put something over it as well. I'm just going to take a little. I'm just going to like fan this so it dries a little faster for the purpose of the video. So we can move on to our next step. Sometimes I use this, not all the time, like when I just feel like being extra. I use my face roller. This is made out of jade. You can really get this anywhere, but wherever you get it, like as far as Amazon and stuff, just make sure it's real jade. It'll tell you in the description. Before I use this, I always clean it off with alcohol and like one of these little pads, because it sits on my dresser and like it can collect dust and stuff like that, and I don't want to put that on my face if it's been sitting out. And I just use this when I have the aloe vera gel on my face sometimes if I have extra time. It's like really soothing for the skin, and I just like how it feels. It has a lot of other benefits, but that's the reason why I use it primarily. Done with that, I'm still letting my face dry a little bit, but for the most part, it's like 80%, 85% dry. So I'm about to go in with the last step, which is my moisturizer. My moisturizer, I use mango butter, but it's 100% pure, it's vegan and cruelty free, and you can use this for like DIY skincare and hair care. So it comes in like a little bag like this, so I'll have that and apply it in my face. If you're not walking around looking greased up, like, are you really moisturized? Don't worry, after you apply this, you're not gonna be looking like this all day. So yeah, my camera died again, but I just continue to rub it in my face. As you can see, it's not really as oily as it was. I melted into my skin. If there is any excess, I just add it to my arms, my chest, like, and go about my day. So yeah, that was my simple skincare routine. Like I said, I don't really have like a YouTuber skin routine. I don't use a lot of products because my skin is very sensitive. So I just try to keep it simple, but I also like that it is effective. I never really have any problems. Some other tips you can use for your skin is just make sure you're staying hydrated. Make sure you're eating well, because I noticed that when I'm eating crazy, like a lot of fast food and stuff like that, I usually start breaking out. Breakouts of acne can also be attributed to genetics. So if a lot of products, certain products don't work for you, don't even be upset. Don't get frustrated, because it's not about the product sometimes. Sometimes it's about genetics, and there's other ways that you could go about it. Also, a good tip to make sure your skin is glowing and it's staying clear and just, you know, it's just looking good, being at its best, because it's not going to be perfect, but just a way to make sure your skin is at its best is just to try to stay stress-free, try to stay positive, you know, try to think of things in a good light. One model that I go by is from the inside out, so if you're glowing on the inside, you're going to glow on the outside, it's going to show. So just make sure you're keeping that in mind. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, make sure you leave them below. Make sure you follow me on Instagram at cxakathalyn. And make sure you follow my other page at spirit@_.spirit. Post a lot of affirmations, a lot of things regarding mental, physical health, anything along those lines that has to do with, you know, alignment and being your best self. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll definitely catch you in the next one.